Hello students, today I have a very important topic in 12th class, that is the motion of the electric dipole in external electric field. The question was asked this year in the NEET exam, so I will discuss to this one.
Two types of electric field. Number one, non-uniform. Electric field. And second, uniform. Uniform electric field.
So now I will take first the non-uniform electric field.
Electric dipole in that I would like to tell you first the non-uniform electric field, that is I think better to tell you. And second is diverging. To converging is that suppose you are having this like this. These the lines of field are converging towards the right. So let this is the electric field here, E1. This is now electric field E2. So what we have that this E2 is greater than E1. Here E2 greater than E1. So net electric field this E is equal to E2 minus E1. So this is towards like this. So this is the increasing electric field. Direction of increasing electric field. तो ये किस तरीके से होगा? This will be like this. From left to right, left to right. Direction of decreasing electric field is taking so from right to left, because here the lines are diverging and here the lines are converging. So this electric field is more than this electric field. So this is the direction of increasing electric field. Now then we have direction of decreasing electric field. Decreasing electric field. ये किस तरीके से होगी? This is like this. In this way. Decreasing on this side, increasing on this side. So this is to be known necessarily that what should be the direction of the net electric field. Number two, diverging electric field. Diverging. Diverging electric field किस तरीके से होगा? Like this. Here the lines are diverging. Here the lines are converging. So if we take here, this is now suppose E1 and this is now your E2. Then here this E2 is less than E1. Less than E1. So net E is equal to, this is equal to E1 minus E2. E1 minus E2. E1 is more than E2. So what we have? That the direction of decreasing electric field. Increasing electric field what was that? Direction of increasing electric field. Now this is increasing on this side. This is in this way. Because this will be towards the E1. And direction of decreasing towards right. This is towards left. Towards left. Here we have towards left. Here towards right. Towards right. So this is what that this is our previous knowledge that we should have when we are giving the external electric field. In case of uniform electric field, there is nothing like this one. But when we are having a non-uniform electric fields, then this is necessary to know the direction of the decreasing electric field and the increasing electric field. Moreover, whenever the question is asked, you are given the field lines. So when these field lines are given there, then you have to know that whether the electric field is diverging or converging. Now I take the electric dipole in non-uniform electric field. Now I have the situation A. The electric dipole in non-uniform electric field so first I take the converging electric field. This is now your suppose converging electric field. Here this is the direction of E. So this is towards the left, so towards the right. Now if I keep the dipole here like this, this is suppose we have this minus Q charge and this is now your plus Q charge. Then definitely this will have the force towards this. So this we have the force. This is now F. Now here we have this E1, here we have this E2. So F equal to, this is your and we have the force like this. This is now force F. So now the force is on the both sides. Now what we have here, that we can just resolve. This is your minus Q. This is your plus Q. Here the direction is like this. This is F. Here the direction is like this. This is F. So just you let this angle is theta from the origin. Now we can have this F cos theta. F is equal to Q E2. On this side Q E2. So this is we write down this Q E2 cos theta. Because of this and here we take the angle theta, then this is in this way QE1 cos theta. So this is our vertical components will have the zero effect because they are collinear, so they will not contribute to the rotation. The components QE2 sin theta and QE1 sin theta will not contribute to the motion of dipole. The net force is how much? Net force. This F. This is equal to. Now this E2 is more than this E1. So we are having this force to be more. So this is now your QE2 minus QE2 cos theta. And this is your what we have this minus QE1 cos theta. So this is your Q and this is your E2 minus E1 cos theta and this is your QE cos theta. This is equal to force F. Force F. It means that this dipole will rotate like this one. So dipole will rotate like this one. So this will be the rotation of the dipole. The electric field, or we find the torque. So you see that this F is not equal to 0. We have so much force. And the torque, this is torque, this is also not equal to 0 because this is the maximum length. This is the maximum length. It means that the dipole. And also we take the potential energy. Energy U equal to minus P E and this is now your cos 90 degrees because this P is perpendicular to E. Here we are having this P perpendicular to E. So this U is equal to 0. This is the standard question. So what we have? The dipole. Will rotate. Clockwise. Clockwise. आप मान लो कि हम इसको उल्टा कर दें, तब क्या होगा? Now in this situation we are having the dipole like this. This is now electric field. This is now E. And suppose we are having the dipole in this way. This is your plus Q and this is now minus Q. Then in this direction we are having this plus Q. So this is not positive in this direction. This is now force F. Here this force will be like this. This is now F. So what we have? That the dipole will move like this. This is also in the direction of clockwise. Because of this E1. That will be like this. And because of that E2, this will be like this. Now if suppose there is a diverging electric field, in diverging electric field this will be like this one. If suppose we place the electric field let this is now your plus Q and this is now your minus Q. So this will experience a force in this direction F. This will experience a force in this direction. This is now F. Again the dipole will rotate. That will be clockwise direction. So the net force F is not equal to 0, and also the torque is not equal to 0. So potential energy will be how much? That will be not so much. Potential energy U equal to minus PE sine cos 0 degree cos 90. So this is equal to 0. This is not so much. So this is what? Well, the diverging one, then this is like this one, and potential energy in the equivalent, this dipole will rotate like this. The dipole. This rotate clockwise. Now this is when we have placed the dipole perpendicular to the electric field. Now suppose dipole is placed parallel to the electric field. Now this B point is here, dipole. Electric dipole placed parallel to external electric field. What we have, that we are having the dipole like this, this is the, like this. So here the electric field is direction of increasing electric field. Now this is like this one. This is not E that we have here, because these lines are converging at this point. Now the dipole is placed, suppose, parallel to this. This is not dipole. This is now your minus Q, this is now your plus Q. Definitely it will have a force, net force towards the right. So force, net force, F. This is like this one, towards right. It means that if we suppose we take the potential energy, U equal to minus PE cos 0 degree. So this is cos 0, this is equal to your minus PE. This is the minimum energy, but since the force is not equal to 0, so the dipole will move in the direction of the electric field. The dipole now if we take the torque, then this torque is also not equal to 0. So this net force F is not equal to 0, and that torque, this is also not equal to 0, because this is a non-uniform electric field, non-uniform electric field. So what we have? When we place parallel to this one, then this will be your 0, definitely. This torque, this is equal to 0. So what we have, that the dipole will move towards right. It will move in this direction. Now P and E are the parallel to this one, the net electric field is towards this one, so this the dipole will move in this direction. And now we have the opposite to this one, then what will happen? अब मैं इसका मान लो कि इसको उल्टा कर देता हूं. नाउ डाइपोल इज लाइक दिस. Now dipole is placed like this. This is suppose your plus Q and this is now your minus Q. This is not dipole parallel to this. Now in this case also force is not equal to zero, but torque is equal to zero. Force, net force. F not equal to zero. So इसके F की direction क्या होगी? This will be like this towards left. And the torque is Q. This is equal to zero. And now we find the potential energy. So potential energy, this U is equal to minus PE cos 180 degree, because now this P, this will be in this direction, so this is opposite to this electric field E. So now here we are having this plus PE. Now this dipole will move in the direction where this will gain the minimum potential energy. Again the force is in this direction, in the same one this, then we will have the dipole. In this sense, when we are having this one, then potential energy U the dipole. Will move towards left. That means in the opposite to the direction of this electric field as shown here. Now suppose I take the dipole in this way, this is not dipole, this is not electric field, this is suppose now plus Q, this is now your minus Q in this direction. So what we have, the force is also not equal to zero, and the torque on this one, that will be equal to zero. Net force F not equal to zero, torque that is equal to zero, now potential energy is U equal to minus PE cos 180 degree, because now P is independent to this. Now P will be towards the left and E is towards the right, so we are ending this one. This is now your minus, this is now plus PE. Now the dipole will move towards the right in the direction of the decreasing length. The direction of decreasing rate. The dipole will move towards right. So as to have minimum potential energy. Minimum potential. So this will move like this. So towards the right. In the direction of the decreasing electricity. In the direction of decreasing electricity. Now this is, I am taking the dipole when placed in the converging and the diverging electric fields. Now suppose if I take the uniform electric field. The dipole in uniform electric field. अब यूनिफॉर्म इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड दे रखा है तो इसके लिए तो हमें सीधा सा ये देखना है कि दिस इज द डाइपोल. This is now electric field A. Uniform electric field है and dipole is placed like this. This is suppose your minus Q, this is now your plus Q. Uniform electric field है तो definitely इसे force का मान zero के बराबर होगा. The force net force F is equal to zero. Torque is equal to U is equal to minus PE cos 0 degree because this is not parallel to this one. So we will have this minus PE. U is equal to minus PE. So what will happen? That dipole will not move, but it will remain stationary because the potential energy is minimum. The dipole.
Thank you.